Don't close it. Please stand clear of doors.
When I moved in Punggol, like in 2007, I could see fields everywhere. So it was very greenery, and we had enough space for, you know, just moving around and all that. Now that it has changed a lot, actually, I could see only buildings everywhere.
Transport congestion actually made me just do not want to step out of the house, or just to have to plan to go somewhere is a difficulty itself. It takes my husband by bus an hour to travel from Sengkang to Punggol. It's a typical day evening. So morning he'll try to actually go in earlier to work. I stayed in Punggol for 2 years without the malls. So getting to a mall is only the Punggol Plaza, which I have to take a bus. And the bus I have to change 2 times. All the marketing and things like that, we had to do it online. There's no way to actually get it.
Wet market we have, as far as I know, it is only one available. So again, the prices is whatever they quote, we need to go and get it. I lived in Chinatown for a year. Chinatown is entirely a different place, it's like a lot of crowded, and it's been a lot of vehicles around. Somehow we didn't feel like, you know, we are staying in a home. The day we decided to buy a flat for ourselves, like we thought, okay, we'll move to some developing place so that we'll have a more younger crowd and we'll have the facilities coming up. My favorite place around Punggol is Riverside, one of my favorite. If we find time, yes, we go for long cycling and all that. My kids are very happy, and we have that feel of staying here for long.